Good afternoon. This is Dorothy Simon over at Cable Channel 3, and I'm sitting in for Jim Lakey. And today is Friday. It is the end of the week, and my, the week has gone by so very quickly. So here we are on Friday, October the 11th, and it's been a beautiful morning so far, but over in the greater Midwest, there's a storm system that is emanating out of the Rockies, and it is bringing into the plains and our region the greater pattern for the weather. It's setting the pattern for the weather. And it brings with it plenty of rain, wind, and a few thunderstorms today. In the east, there will be strong to severe storms with hail and damaging winds. And that will be the major threat to the east of us. And the highs we will see in our region about 70 to 80 degrees. And there should be some much cooler air that will be quite widespread throughout most of the weekend and over all the region. So we should see the temperatures falling somewhat, the highs falling somewhat over the weekend. A stronger system, though, may affect the plains in the Midwest early next week, and it should be a little bit more stormy next week. But right now in the square, we have some cloudless skies, clear blue skies, and it's a comfortable 70 degrees. And after the beautiful soft rain early this morning, the temperatures pleasant, and the humidity is right at 73 degrees. Over the next 6 hours, it will be mostly sunny and windy, and the temperatures should rise up towards the 80s. And the winds coming in from the south-southwesterly, that's been the persistent wind pattern, at about 20 to 25 miles an hour, and gusting somewhat sometimes. So the high today, we should see that right at 84, and tonight it will be mostly clear, and the lows at 52s, the winds north-northwesterly at 10 to 15 miles per hour. That shift in the wind should bring in the colder weather. And the weekend, Saturday, we should see very sunny and clear, the highs in the 76 and the lows 50, the winds at northeasterly at 13 miles per hour, but no rain. And Sunday, it should be partly cloudy with a high at 76 and a low of 60 and a 20% chance of rain on Saturday. And the wind shifting somewhat to the east at about 14 miles per hour. So it should be quite pleasant working outside weather over the weekend. In our community, we want to wish Robert Frisk a happy birthday today. Happy birthday, Robert. And on the 13th, we want to wish Weymouth Allison a happy birthday. Again, if you see these people in our community, please do wish them a happy birthday and cheer them up on their special day. Last night, the city had a send-off party for our EMS director, Mr. Steve Moody, at the county annex. And Mr. Moody has served the community well, and so we want to wish Steve all the success in his new ventures. But let's listen to Bradley Blue as he talks to Mr. Moody.
Hello, this is Bradley Blue. I'm here with Steve Moody, the director of Stafford County EMS Services. He will be leaving us soon, and so I'm here to have a little talk with him and see what's happening. So what brought you to this town?
Okay, I served 28 years in Salina on the Salina Fire Department there as a deputy chief, and went to Leavenworth as a fire chief. And I was at a point in my career with my pension that I needed to go ahead and collect my pension and go on to another place. My daughter-in-law is Kylie, and used to be Eisenhower for the last name, and she's married to my youngest son, and she had told me that they were needing somebody out here that had some issues in the past, and they just they really needed somebody that had some experience, and so I thought it'd be a unique challenge, a different challenge, a different setup. I hadn't worked with volunteers, and it'd be a new challenge for me, and that's what brought me.
Did you ever, at any point in your career, ever think about changing directions?
Not sure if I understand into another career.
Yeah.
No, you know, when I got involved in emergency service, I'd started out as a carpenter. Mm-hmm. And I thought it's awful cold in Kansas, and I thought that, you know, possibly might have some downtime and be unemployed. Another gentleman that was working with me worked at the fire department. And I thought that'd be a great job to work, and I could still do my carpenter job. And really loved working emergency service and really never stopped loving it.
So what's your favorite part about the job?
My favorite part of the job is the interaction with the people. And we do EMS, fire, and emergency management. That's we do all three here under me. Now that is going to change. But interacting with the people, especially you take an ambulance ride with somebody to Wichita, you've got about an hour and a half. And if they're not in terrible pain, you can learn a lot about a person in an hour and a half, and they can learn a little bit about you, and you can get to know them, and that's what I consider the most important part of, and what I've loved the most.
So what's the most intense situation that you've ever encountered?
The most intense? I've had quite a number of those. Over time, it kind of helps you stay calm during them particular things. The most intense time, though, I would say we had a major water rescue in Salina, and it actually wasn't me that went down to rescue the gentleman. Two fellows were floating down the river, and it was after a major long period of rain. And the Smoky Hill River was flowing bank to bank. And it's the cutoff channel where these two young fellows had decided that they were going to float down it in a small boat, small inflatable. And what happened was it overturned well before they got to the rapids and immediately sucked one of them under, and he was, we didn't recover him until days later where we shut the water off at Canopolis. But the other gentleman was on a young fellow was able to get up on a big tree trunk right in the middle of the river, roaring. We brought in a helicopter. It couldn't navigate it. We shot a rope across the channel, which was 100 and some feet across, and we brought a rope across there, and we set up a rope system, and we were going to drop, but it was so loud you couldn't hear anything, and we dropped a life jacket down into him. Mm-hmm. With the idea that that was up to the rope still, and we were going to have him put that life jacket on, and then we're going to pull him out. He unsnapped it. Mm-hmm. And so what we had to do is we had to drop one of our firefighters into the water and float him into that gentleman, and then hook him up and then pull them both out. That was the most stressful moment in my career, and mostly because I was responsible for that firefighter.
And last question, what is the thing that you're going to miss most about this job when you leave?
The people by far, and I mean, you know, the people that make up Stafford County Emergency Service. You know, volunteers are great everywhere, but volunteers in Stafford County, I really put them above a lot of others. Yeah. Because they don't do it for the thrill, they do it because it needs to be done. And you have some of the most qualified and the most intelligent people that you'd ever run into. And you know, I've worked full-time service, and I've put Stafford County people at their level or above in many of the people that we have serving Stafford County.
Thank you. This has been Bradley Blue with Steve Moody here, and thank you for watching.
Tomorrow, Saturday, It's the scouting for food. And I suppose everybody saw these beautiful leaflets that were hung on the doors. That's to remind us that the Boy Scout is collecting food, and they do a great job collecting food for the St. John Food Bank. And so please leave your bounty on the front door, mark it clearly, and they shall be picking up all day tomorrow. The items that they most need are canned items, meats, fruits, vegetables, peanut butter, and dry pasta. And they are in need of monetary contributions. And please make those payable, make checks payable to the St. John Food Bank. And if you still need some more information, do call them over at 549-6499. And we've been talking about the flu shots because it's just a season for the flu shots. So don't forget also that over at the Stafford County Department of Health, they're giving the flu shots. And remember that the Medicare will pay for your flu shots, so there should be no cost to you if you're older or 65 or older. And they also give the shingles shot, and your Part D will pay for those shingles shots. So do call them over at the Stafford County Department of Health for any of those flu shots or the shingles shots. And again, mark your calendars for the 16th. We've been telling you about the First United Methodist Women's Bazaar and Soup Supper. That will be on the 16th. That's coming up, the new week coming. And they should be serving chili or chicken noodle soup, a sandwich, dessert, and a drink, and all that for only $7. And if for the younger people, the children, 10 or under, it's just $3.50. And they will have a bazaar of baked goods, jelly, and craft items. And all donations will go to the mission work that the UMW, the United Methodist Women, support. They do a great job supporting several different mission works. So talk to the people over there when you come by for the supper this evening, and they will tell you more. And that will be at 4:30. Starts at 4:30 and go through till it's finished or until 7 o'clock. In a similar vein, mark your calendars for October the 20th, that's Sunday. And it's the St. John's Catholic Parish. They have a similar affair. It's the 27th annual turkey dinner, and there will be prizes there. There will be a queen size quilt will be up for a raffle, bicycles and various gift certificates. And if you do need to have a beautiful turkey dinner delivered to you on that day, just give them a call with your name and address, and they will be happy to bring it over for you. And the cost of that is only $10. So do mark your calendars for that. I'm looking forward to that turkey dinner. It's a good turkey meal. We have over at this Maxville Center today, they're serving up a chicken and stuffing, Harvard beans with roll, and a tropical fruit salad. That's on their menu today at the Maxville Center. And then on Monday, they're serving up beef noodles, Scandinavian vegetables, strawberries and peas. And then on Tuesday, look forward to chicken parmesan, baked potatoes, peas and carrots, and with the usual bread, tea, and coffee of your choice. And at the Sunflower Center right here in St. John, today, they're serving up a Hawaiian chicken, braised broccoli, seasoned carrots, a cherry salad, and a mandarin orange cake, and usual condiments. And on Monday, it should be glazed ham, glazed pit ham, raspberry potato, cauliflower and cheese, sliced fresh tomato and cucumber salad, and plenty of tea and coffee that goes along with that. So again, don't forget, if you need the meals delivered, please call either center and they will be happy to arrange for delivery of the daily meal. It's a great service for the sick and shut in. Our food for thought. We've been talking about food that fight the flu, and today our food is yogurt. And we know that the yogurt and other probiotics have a lot of beneficial bacteria, and they are good for strengthening the immune system. And if you're not a fan of yogurt, try cottage cheese and sauerkraut. So today, our food for thought, yogurt and all other fermented foods. Have a great weekend, and don't forget to set your bags out for the Boy Scout. Good afternoon.